Ah, the statue of Busticus. Okay, I know what you're thinking. Yes, the dev team from Hearthstone and the devs from Elder Scrolls finally had that world-changing orgy you've been dreaming about. What? You haven't dreamt of that? Great, now I look like the weird one. Ooh, story! I don't know what they're saying or what's going on. Well, time to make it up myself. The Order of the Angry Skylight Sword People and the Order of the Banner Makers banded together with the Ocean Serpent to battle Cthulhu Cloud and become the victors via shiny stuff and these big ships of creepy eyeball. Oh, what the hell? The almighty Narwhal was pleased with the victory and gifted them with flight and flushing toilet skies. Revelation. Sure, why not?
Huh. Odd that it's already winter when you forgot about fall.
Damn it. That's it. I'm bringing in an expert.
Hey, Wibbles.
What?
What am I doing wrong?
Everything. Now, leave me alone. Can't be seen with you.
Why? Because I'm the Hive Leader?
Yes. And it has absolutely nothing to do with your terrible playing.
Okay. Love you. Wait, that wasn't helpful at all.
The camera does not adjust and is pulled in pretty tight, meaning you'll be shooting at and getting shot by enemies you cannot see.
That's fun!
So as everyone else begins to run, naturally I take up arms and attempt to slay the beast. Don't worry, I'll save. I'm sure you're fine. A little fire never hurt nobody. All right, I got this.
Ah!
Hey, I got him! Uh-oh. I pissed him off. Hey, man, I'm really sorry about that, but I'm sure you're a perfectly reasonable dragon, right? Right?
F*** you, bitch.
I'm all right. It was just my heart. Didn't need that anyway. No, don't eat it. It's full of cholesterol.
P.S. This is gonna get real spoiler heavy. So if you don't want issue 14 spoiled for you, go ahead and pause this, go play it, and then come back and listen to me make fun of it. I'll wait. Okay, that's enough.
It's the little things, really. I know that I've mentioned it before, but I love that there are random NPCs walking the streets and roads. It just brings a sense of realism to the world for me. Even if sometimes they appear out of nowhere, but come on, that happens in real life too.
What? It doesn't.
Oh man, I should probably get my eyes checked. Find one of these. It will give you a triangle. Fill in all of the triangles. That's it. And that's your motivation. Now go. Actually, I think that's where HIVElights Drifter is kind of lacking. I'm assuming there's a story here that I've completely missed, but I've completely missed it.
In this test, we had 7 classes. The Confessor, the Knight, the Legionnaire, the Champion, the Ranger, the Druid, and the Myrmidon? Minotaur, f*** it. The latest expansion for Rift is here. Starfall Prophecy. And with it, I'm pretty sure Tryon has lost their f***ing marbles. Either that, or they're just trolling us at this point. I'm fighting squirrels, planting lawn gnomes, talking to bears, and playing with unicorns in the glint of friendship. If I didn't know any better, I'd say I was on LSD. Well, maybe. What do you have to say, Talking Banana?
I'm your wife.
Don't lie to me, Banana!
In Nosgoth, you get to take part in an age-old battle. Hunters versus vampires.
Finally, I get to kill those sparkly bastards.
Team Jacob, motherfucker!
And for those of you watching in the future who don't get that joke, that means the world has won. You're welcome.
It's me, Deadpool! Your favorite homicidal maniac. Bang, 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 bang! It decapitates, it disembowels, and all for the low, low price of only $29.95. Plus shipping and handling. Characters talk about sex, make innuendo about you having sex with their daughters, and make jokes about you raping their daughters. Oh my god, what the f*** is wrong with you, old man? God, this game is weird.
And I could easily kick all of your
ass. Shh, you're just supposed to be here. No more talking.
Aw.
Stupid this. Do I get to talk?
Dear god, no.
Aw.
It's cool, man. They don't let me talk either.
Who are you?
It's not important.
Come on! Step number one, don't play. That's right, the first step to becoming an Overwatch success is not playing. No. Start a YouTube channel, pop open some loot crates, and overreact like crazy.
Oh my god, no way! I got that skin that's slightly more purplish than the original skin! I can't believe it!
And profit. Overwatch success. Okay, apparently you all actually want to play Overwatch. Fine, whatever.
Are you okay with being average, mediocre, run-of-the-mill, plain Jane, vanilla, ordinary, typical, normal, a C-plus at best? Then you might want to play Riders of Icarus, the most passable, serviceable, straight-laced MMO of 2016. In fact, it does everything so...
Right. I don't think that's the word I'm looking for.
Safe!
And you also get your choice of weapon now. I went old school ninja and chose a bow staff for my melee weapon because Donatello is my favorite ninja turtle. And that is relevant. And I went with throwing knives for my secondary. Who says you shouldn't bring knives to a gunfight? More like you shouldn't bring a you to a me fight. Because my knives will enter your body and do serious damage to your internal organs. My smack talk needs work.
So, you've decided to play Black Desert.
Yeah.
Whoa, slow down there, killer. You're not ready just yet.
But I've played an MMO before.
Well, good. That means precisely d**k.
What?
While Black Desert may appear to be very similar on the surface, if you dig down, you'll suddenly realize you don't know s**t.
But can't I just ask questions when I get confused or look at a tutorial online?
Sure, but if you ask questions, you're gonna look like an idiot and we're all gonna laugh at you. Do you want that?
No.
And tutorials often use complicated lingo that will only make it worse. That's why I'm here to dumb things down to your level.
What's that supposed to mean?
You know what it means.
You've got bird people, bear people, whatever the f*** this is. Humans, a bug race that have a hive mind. Oh, we're done here, call it to search. Having a hive mind would be so cool. Hey, how are you?
Oh, hey, I'm good.
Man, I'd so hit that.
I can hear you.
What?
We have a hive mind, you idiot.
Wait, does that mean you can hear all my thoughts?
Yes, you're a sick, sick bug.
Oh. So, you want a mate?
I will cut off your thorax.
Okay, Warcraft, we need to have a talk. We can't keep going through this. Yes, I loved you once, but that was a long time ago. I've moved on, yet here you are again. You do this every 2 years like clockwork. You practically beg me to come back, claiming you've changed and that you're different and better now. But it's never enough. We always get back together only to break up just a month or two later. It's just not enough for me any- Wait, you're giving me a legendary weapon right off the bat? God, I've missed you.
I did get better though once I picked the medic class. Not much better, mind you, but sometimes I survived long enough to heal someone. The middle of a space war and here I am, a f***ing doctor. Damn it. Before we begin, I have to tell a little story. A little over a year ago, I applied to be the comedy writer for a game called Battleborn. There you go, that's the story. And seeing as I'm still doing this, you can guess I didn't get the job. But don't worry, I'm not bitter or anything, and I definitely haven't been planning my revenge for over a year. And this definitely won't affect the video in any way whatsoever. P.S. If the writer of Battleborn is watching this, this isn't about you. There are much larger forces at work here. Now, on with the completely unbiased review. The other weapon you have at your disposal are your awesome parkour skills. Jump up walls, run on walls, slide, do a spinny jump thing, and of course, double jump. This is it. Prepare the final countdown.
Save that for when we win!
Captain's log. Stardate Tuesday. Well, this has been an interesting few days. I'm finally captain of my own ship! And all that needed to happen was for my original captain to go bonkers, kill his first officer, and then for me to stab him in the back and take over. I totally earned this. I can't wait to explore space. It's gonna be so boring. Who would have guessed vast amounts of nothingness means nothing happens? Well, if you need me, I'll be in the holodeck.
Now, no doubt you've already seen quite a few videos on Overwatch at this point. I actually almost did one myself a while back, but the game just didn't have a whole lot to it in earlier tests. You just picked a character and killed the enemy. Bing bada boop!
For one, I had a movie? Who was in it? Wait, we let him have another go at it? After this? Wow. Okay, apparently the human race is a lot more forgiving than I thought. How'd it turn out?
really well, Mr. Poole.
Oh, well, do I get residuals?
No.
Then I don't care. But technically, all characters should now be equal. Right? If only there was a way to test this. Oh my god, Segway! Update 12 also introduced dueling, which is another thing that should have been in ESO since day one. Anyway, finally, a way to test your mettle against another person. One-on-one. Mano-y-mano. Bring it on it! Oh, f**k. Seriously? That duel lasted all of 15 seconds. That's what I get for picking the healer class and then specking to healing and then trying to duel. Screw it. I'm just gonna go heal some dungeons and cry silently while I do. This is so rewarding. And I am going to clean up this mess.
I can hear you, you know.
I know, I was talking to you.
You forgot your comms were on, didn't you?
Yeah.
Can you please just get to the factory and look for supplies?
Yeah, I'm on it.
This is how you obtain quest and quest objectives. Such as this dismembered hand I found. I need to find its owner, which you think would be easy, but apparently not. Is this yours? Is this your hand? Excuse me, are you missing a hand?
MXM is actually an amazing game that gives me hope for the future of a genre that is really all about demolishing your hopes, dreams, and stripping you of your humanity. The name Tasty brings two things to mind. One, a toddler who can't spell, and two, some kind of fruit-based golf game. Throw in the subtitle Lethal Tactics and you have me sold. I would play the shit out of that. Welcome to Trinium Wars. Trinium? Trinium? Ah, who gives a f***? An MMO that looks, plays, feels, and performs like a browser MMO made in 2012. There's only one problem. It came out in March of 2016 and doesn't play in a browser. Oh boy. My new favorite quest was being the quest giver for a bunch of kobolds. I sent this one to his death. I feel accomplished.
That's a big kitty. Aw, he's hungry. It's okay, we all get a little snackish sometimes. Wait, what the? A lion, goat, snake. Now there's an orgy I do not want to see or be a part of, although I am intrigued by the logistics.
Has boring old suburbia got you down? Do you sometimes feel like you just need to get away? Then it's time you paid a visit to the new New York City. Due to the recent apocalypse, the Big Apple is better than ever. Yes, it's still cold as f***, but now you can take a stroll through beautiful downtown without all those inconveniences of old. Traffic is nearly a thing of the past. No longer do you have to worry about crazy taxis, pedestrians, bike messengers, or people handing out flyers. In fact, you can walk into your favorite coffee shop with no lines. And you won't even have to be annoyed by hipsters trying to get you to read their screenplays. The new New York City's crime rate is also way down. Muggings, robberies, nearly non-existent. Because if it does happen, you can just shoot the f***ers without any repercussions. Homicide numbers are pretty much the same though. And if you enjoy your stay, buying an apartment in the city has never been easier. I just got myself a great one bedroom, one bath for super cheap. Ignore the dead body. So visit the new New York City. Oddly enough, the apocalypse made us better.
I think a skilled player could probably get extremely good at it and look f***ing awesome doing it. Warping around, flipping, dodging, killing. Me? Not so much. I look like that awkward white guy trying to break dance. But really, I'm just flopping around on the ground like a fish. I think Kotet is some of the strongest storytelling SWTOR has ever done. It's engaging, funny, sad, and all of those other emotions I'm told normal humans feel. So off I go on my leisurely stroll to gather the pieces and assemble the one ring to rule them all. I think I messed up. No? That's how it's supposed to look? Really? Okay.
And yes, I did experience a few glitches while out and about, but here's some highlights. Man, I'm not sure I can take this guy. Oh, okay. You just stand there while I shoot you then, that's cool. I'm just a corpse hoppin'. I'm just a corpse hoppin'. Hoppin', hoppin', hoppin'. I'm just gonna go up this ramp here and up, guess not. Help, I'm stuck on a 1-inch step. Oh, I can fly, that's cool. Gun, are you gonna fire? Hello? Hello? Oh, apparently I'm using my invisible sword. Huh, I'm firing negative bullets. Well, that just doesn't make sense at all.
Back in the day, your character just used to zen out in space.
Dude, these planets are all like really tiny.
But I figured I'd just go with science because, you know, Klingons and science go together like peanut butter and broccoli.
Let's fix that. There we go! Now, I've already mentioned these guys a few times. Much like any boss from the medieval age, hiring slaves is how you get most of your work done. Once you invest in some lodging, simply go to a contractor and purchase some humans. But if you can get them, goblins are better. Does that make me racist?
He couldn't stand a fucking chance against a dinosaur.
Oh boy, I throw my 12-sided dice at you. Crap, I rolled a one.
I decided to play the Dark Lord. Figured I gotta repay him somehow. What, how do you think I got this far? Talent? I think we all know that's not true.
Now, I'll be honest, I'm not that familiar with the Warhammer universe. I mean, I played Warhammer Online a while back, but that's about it. What I do know is that I can piss off a lot of people by saying, Warhammer 40K ripped off StarCraft!
Oh god, please! It was just a joke! I know Warhammer 40K came first!
But I need something to really challenge me in the meantime. What do we got? Damn it. Damn it! Damn it! Yeah, this'll do. Orcs must die? You know, I for one am against this anti-orc agenda that the mainstream media is pushing. Orcs are people just like you and me. Terrifying looking people who want to kill everyone who isn't an orc. But that's only because of our widely held prejudice against these poor people who have suffered at the hands of— What? Really? Apparently orcs just ate my family, so f*** them.
I was actually really concerned that the game was going to be far too complex for my tiny brain to comprehend, but it wasn't. Or at least I think it wasn't. If it was, then my brain would be too tiny to comprehend that it was too tiny to comprehend, and then I'd just be caught in a loop that I really don't want to be in.
You actually only create one pawn. So I made Bill Murphy, editor of MMORPG.com. He's a dwarf who talks like this. He's also a character I made in the game.
It also helped that it was 50% off and that I found out it gave me a free max level character. Don't judge me. I'm lazy. See? I judge myself, so you can't.
And somehow it doesn't hurt any less.
It's extremely customizable, while oddly not being customizable enough. For example, your wizard will pretty much look like an old man no matter what you do. Talk about stereotyping. Not all wizards are old men, Black Desert. Just look at Dumbledore? This isn't helping. Harry Potter, there we go.
Here's one of the areas that Hero Song shines. Look at all of the classes! There's so many, it almost brings a tear to my eye. And look at all of the races, which all kind of look alike. Look at all of the classes! However, I do actually suggest questing, because where Starfall Prophecy really shines is in its writing. It is honestly pretty damn funny. If I didn't know any better, I'd say I wrote it. Well, maybe. Banana?
Oh, for the love of God, seek help!
Oh, Banana, you slay me.
But don't you dare cross me.
Step number one, pick the cute ones. Ah yes, the age-old trick of using your stunning good looks to distract the enemy. Oh yeah, you know you want a piece. Even with the non-sexy butt poses, your amazing beard should stun all the ladies. And just look at how huge this guy is. You know he's gotta have a huge hammer. Or maybe the enemy team is into the bad boy thing. I mean, he smokes. And this guy literally smokes. You know, if you're into that sort of thing. He's part machine, if you catch my drift. He's full machine, if you catch my drift.
Oh, and how about the cutscenes that the game forces you to watch while you still get hit? Seriously! This game sucks!
Hey, what are you doing?
What? Holy
Whoa!
What the hell?
Man!
What?
All those hit me, thanks.
The game is currently in early access, so I figured I would go ahead and take a first look to see how it's coming along and possibly ruin my hype, because that's how early access works.
Wait, Daredevil was actually good? Twice? Jeez, if they made him interesting, I wonder what they did with the Fantastic Four. Oh. But that's why this is just part one of my two-part series, Legion. Come up with subtitle. Damn it.
I found myself actually using melee a lot more than in the past, and guns are pretty much the same.
Pew 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 pew.
Screw that, let's slice some people. Oh god! That's a torso. And there's his legs. You get to pretend you're an investment mogul as you invest in farms, mines, warehouses, factories, and real estate. Then yank your support out from underneath them with absolutely no warning whatsoever. Isn't destroying people's livelihoods fun? Ah!
Me, that's terrifying. I'm bumping this back down to a C+ for the nightmare-inducing imagery. And back up to a B- for the inadvertent hilarity.
I personally did not care for Dark Souls 2. I feel that that game somehow had less soul in it than the others. Oh, shut up.
I was actually pretty immersed, which is rare, at least for the first few hours. Maybe it lessens over time, but from what I played, I was impressed. Woo, that fight was intense. I'll be in the holodeck.
Now the game has character creation. You know what, let's not talk about character creation. However, the melee combat is a bit more floaty. It was hard to tell if I was hitting anything. I also look like I'm a raver.
Me and my trusted pet, Bill Murphy, editor of MMORPG.com, visit the lab of a crazed scientist known only as Timey, who decides to test a previously unstable and non-working training program on me and this giant puppy. She also clearly has deep-seated issues regarding her short stature.
Dragon's Dogma has finally made its way to PC. Pfft, about time. It only came out in 2012. But better late than never, I suppose. Maybe not.
Get ready for some pulse. Pounding. Roadside assistance.
It was a love story unlike any other. Based on the tragic events of—
Oh, that ended fast.
You find out that these cultists have been digging, and their digging disturbed something. Something ancient. But what?
Aladdin's genie. Man, apparently 10,000 years will give you a crick in the neck. And the desire to destroy the world with earthquakes. Okay, really, they just disturbed the genie's lamp. Now it's up to you to fix it. Why you? Because this guy said so. Now go!
Ah, I can acknowledge the existence of Spider-Man again.
What, Sony? You couldn't make Spidey work? Should've made him rated R. The amazing f***ing Spider-Man!
That way you're only spending a small amount of money to try something out, rather than spending all of your money on something you may not even like. Kinda like prostitution. Why am I making that analogy so much? Okay, so we've covered progression, questing, modding, crafting, outfits. What am I missing? Oh right, the Dark Zone. Okay, quick reminder in case you don't know what the Dark Zone is. The Dark Zone is an open PvP area full of strong AI enemies as well as the scum of the human race. If you die in this area, you'll drop anything that you've picked up while in the Dark Zone, along with losing some Dark Zone experience and currency. Dark Zone experience and currency are both used to buy Dark Zone equipment, which is typically better equipment than you'll find in PvE areas. You can also go rogue in the Dark Zone, which rewards you for killing other players, but also gives other players benefits for killing you, and severely punishes you should you die as a rogue. Also, any equipment that you gather in the Dark Zone has to be extracted via helicopter, which takes time but is widely broadcasted throughout the entire zone, essentially painting a giant f***ing target on your face. Long story short, bring some friends that you trust, otherwise they might kill you and steal your Does that cover it? Maybe, maybe not. Nah, I don't care, I'm going to bed.
Welcome to Twin Saga, the dirtiest game I've ever played. Yeah, you heard me. This game is f***ing filthy. Yes, you, I'm talking to you. You're a dirty, dirty girl.
And I like it.
Now where were we?
About to kick their asses.
Was I speaking to you?
That's it!
Frolic with the indigenous wildlife of Emberbill.
What the f*** is that?
Suddenly, all of this makes sense. But no one remembers that game, and that's fine because no one cared then and no one cares now!
Hey, wanna try this new drug?
I guess so.
Alright, smoke this crappy cigarette for a few weeks, and then I'll slowly move you up to something better. Hey, wanna try this new drug?
I guess so.
Alright, here's some cocaine, some heroin, and a few dozen hookers. I'll see you in a few days when you need more.
I enjoy these larger boss battles because it truly feels like you're slaying an epic beast. Well, maybe less epic and more gene-splicing experiment gone terribly wrong. I mean, a goat? Why not something cool like a shark? Because right now you're only two-thirds terrifying and one-third weird-tasting milk.
However, actual customization is super deep. You can really change your character's body to fit whatever you— Wah! Nightmare fuel! You're supposed to go in the litter box! Holy sh! What is that? Ah! Where's my gun? And I forgot to load! Crap, 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 crap! Load, 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 load!
Hi. My name is Hive, and I'm an addict.
Hi, Hive.
I think a lot of you know what I'm feeling. That desire, that craving, that need. For me, it was crack. Ever crack. It may not have been my first drug of choice, but it was definitely the first to give me that... it was something else. I felt it slightly over the years with others, but it was never as good. And everyone said you could never capture that again, but boy, how wrong you were. Because Black Desert, oh man, I cannot stop thinking about it. Oh god, I've relapsed.
Here's my totally legit review of The Living Story Season 3. Stuff happens. Stuff also doesn't happen. And then it's over. Your mileage may vary depending on your amount of caring.
Oh hey, it's that guy! I remember him. Still have no idea what he is though. Is he just a guy who has two livers attached to his face? Cause that would make sense. You never know when you're gonna need a face liver.
However, the game is not without its graphical glitches. Dude, you appear to be missing something.
I don't know, that's just my opinion. What say you, Banana? Banana? Banana?
Oh god, I hate the banana!
Welcome to part two of my two-part series, Legion. I gave up on coming up with a subtitle. Strange earthquakes have been shaking things up. And apparently people don't like being shaken. Or stirred, as I've learned from personal experience.
What does that even mean?
So it's up to you to stop them. Why you? Because this guy said so. Now go!
Well, look no further. I'm here to help you unapologetically murder your way to the top. Let's get to it. Which brings us to a segment I like to call Being a D**k with the Hive Leader.
Warning. Anticipate. Warning. Your division affiliation has been disavowed. You are now marked as rogue.
For just the bow staff, it's gonna be at least 12 hours. And that's excluding the amount of time to gather the materials. And 12 hours? I could get to max level in like 6 WoW clones in that amount of time.
The game is set in a sci-fi post-apocalyptic world where only 5,034, that is an oddly specific number.
Occasionally you'll come across people in need of help. I almost don't want to help this guy though. It's kind of funny.
Brutally slaughter hundreds of henchmen.
Mr. Poole, we don't actually want to kill people.
Says you, Mr. Disembodied Voice Guy. Whoa! I am a f***ing badass. Did you see that sh-? Even my character knows he's a badass. If the mayor's daughter was watching this, all of her innuendo is gonna turn into in her endo if you catch my not-so-subtle drift.
Round 3. Remember that
run like hell!
Yeah, the same applies here. Well, it's more like walk slowly like hell. There we go.
After each match, you were given an amount of gold based on your performance. Kind of like being a prostitute. Wait, that's not right. Really, it's just bros doing bro stuff. Pitching tents with one another, cooking food, eating said food.
Why can't I quit you?
That's a big spider. We're gonna need a bigger can of Raid.
Oh wow, big dinklebots. Talk about compensating.
Oh, I hope I'm dreaming. Oh, I sure hope I'm dreaming.
Not dreaming!
No, 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 no.
Hey, I got someone! Oh, there we go.
Woo, for a second there, I thought I might actually be getting better or something.
If you don't know anything about Black Desert and you just see this, you might just have a brain aneurysm. And after some awesome imagery that makes me wonder if I accidentally took acid, you wake up at a campfire and cough up some blood. Just a typical Saturday morning for the Hive Leader. I have issues.
This is of course my flimsy excuse for finally doing a video on the game several months late. However, I kind of just explained the entire thing. Pick a character, kill the enemy. Bada bing, bada boop! Unfortunately though, there are some things you'll have to do yourself. I don't know who this is more degrading for, me or the cow. Never mind, it's definitely me.
I'll just join this person's server here and sit through a loading screen. I think it's broken. It's fine, I don't need you. I'll just start my own server. So once you fail on your first attempt because you don't have the answer yet, and if you succeed on your first attempt, congratulations on cheating, you'll find that your good friend Indy has left you the answer. Thanks, Indy. Sorry about you falling to your death, but trust me, it's better than the alternative.
And all of this is accompanied by characters spouting dialogue at you.
We're doomed! We're all doomed! Captain, you slapped me!
That's not funny!
Die. 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 Did I do it? Oh, you're not dead! Congratulations on the promotion. Keep working hard there, buddy. And one day, you too might be a hive leader. Unless I murder you for attempting to usurp the throne, you f***ing traitor.
The enemies vary with anything from tiny goblins to giant bears. Bears. Mankind's worst enemy. Man, they're just a bunch of throwback jokes this week.
It's also a good place to mac on your lady. Or the other way around. Yeah, you get it, girl.
Ah! I don't want to play right now. Get him off, get him off, get him off! So, there you go. That's some of the most important aspects of the Black Desert economy that I've dumbed down so that you can understand.
So that's it?
Yep.
But that seems more complicated than it actually is.
Nobody asked you!
On the ground, you also get to take along a companion like your first officer. They each have their own specialization, so you'll want to pick one that complements your playstyle. Let's just hope they don't have a red shirt, huh? It's Trek humor. I'll be in the holodeck.
Instead of questing, you're going to be grinding out levels against dozens upon dozens of monsters.
I love it.
A lot of people may not actually like mob grinding though, so use your discretion.
Now for the gameplay!
It's really, really bad.
For starters, your character controls like a block of wood, glued to a cinder block. And each spec plays entirely different than it used to. Except for Holy. That's pretty much the same. You click heal.
Hi, welcome to The Hive 5, a show that contains a pointless list of 5 arbitrary things made by an admittedly arbitrary person. And yet despite this, many of you will still feel compelled to disagree with me on a deeply personal level. Yay for me and my therapy bills. Naturally, you try to help out, but right before you're attacked, out pops a fairy out of my body. And everyone seems pretty cool with it. There's no questions asked, they just kinda go on like this is a normal everyday occurrence. Damn, this game is weird.
Rock climb the green bluffs of greenery with the only surviving plants in Ember Bay. And here you can try one of Ember Bay's famous Ember apples.
Ah! Ah! Ah!
Mm. You know how in some MMOs the game levels you down to certain areas to help keep lower level content relevant? So yeah, you can explore and still have a challenge. But don't you dare go into higher level content areas. Otherwise, well, yeah, that.
The Hunger Dome.
Sure, I could eat. I think I misunderstood what was going on here. But in Hero's Song,
death is only the beginning.
Because you are then thrown into the underworld, where you can also die. And if you die in the underworld, you die in real life. Just kidding, your character's permanently dead. Oh, fine, good, great, grand, whatever. New character!
You're ready to get out there and do more quests. But before you do, I've invented a little game. I call it Murphy Tossing. It's like dwarf tossing, but only using Bill Murphy. Blow him up. Throw him off cliffs. Use him as a weapon. Why? Because he can't do anything about it, and also it's fun.
You could be stealthy if you want, but since I'm a giant albino rhino with a machine gun...
This is where you can use any of your yellow skills. Are you all keeping up? Are we okay? I don't know why I asked that, I don't care. But I have now played through quite a few of them thanks to my higher level friends. And naturally, the enemy scaled, so I'm helping. Can't hit me, can't hit me, can't hit me. Oh, me, I've lost myself, what else is left? Oh right, just the best part.
Fishing.
Which you can do while AFK. This is Little Gut and his one-handed handler. Has no one in this universe heard of getting a puppy?
Wait, why with the whooshing sound? What's with the whooshing sound? I don't like whooshing sounds. I'm brave, I'm brave, I'm brave.
You are the embodiment of bravery.
There it is again! Who better to lead a race of hive-minded beings than the hive leader? Nobody, that's who. So after running around this f***ing hellscape, because these little bastards had me running around collecting random ball things, my character then tripped on said balls, likely due to heat stroke.
And grow... wings!
Ah! Oh, that would have hurt like hell. Sephiroth to the rescue! I did not see a single solitary person during my entire time playing. It's slightly eerie. Speaking of eerie, I'm pretty sure this cat lady is in heat. That is the only acceptable explanation for whatever the f*** this is.
So you'll be running around trying to discover secret areas, unlocking triangles, and once you have enough triangles, you can take on a boss. These punks are tough. Damn it. Damn it. Okay, this time I got it. Damn it, damn it. How long did I even last on that one? Oh, come on! But when you finally down a boss, yeah, in your face! And then it's back on acid as, ah! I'm okay.
Map and level objectives are for losers. Your ultimate goal should be to kill. How else are you gonna get to play the game? By being support? F*** support.
Check me out. Yar, me matey. Stop, you have the right to remain silent. That has never worked on me. Howdy. Huh. I have boobs. This feels right.
I want to play healers, dammit! And I always secretly and often publicly hated Guild Wars 2 for attempting to do away with them. I mean, come on, self-healing?
What is this blasphemy?
Okay, I've gathered quite a bit now and I think I'm ready to head back to base and oh no.
Die! F**k, I missed!
No, 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 no! The best thing I've found about questing in Legion is that I feel important while questing. I mean, I know all of these people are the chosen one, but come on, I'm the chosen one. For example, this guy makes my torpedoes hit harder while this one repairs my hull. That sounded vaguely sexual. I'll be in my holodeck.
You need to kill a human and then execute them by ripping out their throat and drinking their blood.
Oh no, someone let out the YouTube trolls again!
Do everything right, and you will become the new Eternal Champion.
Congratulations, you murdering psycho. I know, I don't think many of you play MOBAs for its PvE, and if you do, I'm pretty sure you're fairly bored of playing nothing!
Visit the ancient Spewing Head Island, where streams of lava flow at a comfortable 2,000 degrees.
Relax on the pristine brown dirt beaches of Hot Cocoa Beach. Just make sure to watch out for demon crabs of varying sizes. Bring friends.
I personally am digging Black Desert, a lot more than I actually thought I would. Does that mean I think you should play it? I don't f***ing care, make up your own mind. I got fishing to do.
The intro screen lets you know exactly what you're in for straight from the get-go. Lots of adorableness with a tinge of sexual deviancy, because if I didn't know any better, I'd say that guy's not wearing pants.
You may just bleed out, allowing you to crawl around looking for help and giving your team a chance to resurrect you, or gives your enemy the chance to execute you in horrific ways.
Oh god.
But of course, the opposite is also true.
I'm a f***ing doctor!
After that, the doctor leaves and it's off to your next location, where you'll talk to some statues. Trust me, in context, it's still really confusing.
Safe! Oh, not so safe. We can rebuild him. We have the technology. We can make him bigger, better, faster, better than he was before. He will be a Super Saiyan.
Oh man, if I don't get an A, my parents are gonna kill me. And don't you tell me an S is better than an A. My parents won't buy that sh**.
Step number one, play Bastion.
Okay, apparently that wasn't good enough either. Jeez, what do y'all want from me?
Let's see if dwarves can fly. They cannot fly.
I don't wanna go out there.
You gotta go out there.
I don't wanna.
You gotta.
I don't wanna! I better be getting paid well for this. I am an A-lister now, and I've got my eye on a sweet ride.
Yeah!
I would like to officially put all important NPCs in the world of Azeroth on my Deadpool because damn!
I haven't really looked into the cash shop, so maybe it's outrageous? Again, I have not a clue. And that's pretty much the state of being for me.
All those explosions better not have hurt my holodeck.
The druid, which can heal with the forces of life. However, this has to be balanced out by dealing damage with the forces of death.
If you don't, you'll die, like I did. That seriously confused me for a bit. I'm tired of games taking themselves so damn seriously. Your game, lighten up. On the other hand, you could take yourselves a bit more seriously. I mean, seriously. I did not add that sound effect. That's in the game.
Actually, here is where you'll begin to notice that the game is in fact from 2012. The graphics. Yeah.
We ain't got no time for that sh**! We got dragons, bitch!
In these boxes are a random assortment of the aforementioned voice packs, sprays, emotes, and skins. That's about it. Or at least that I've seen. A bing bada boop!
With update 12, I feel ESO is finally becoming the game it should have been all along. AKA one worth my time. I kid, but seriously. You'll also have to set taxes and build up your political relations.
Making friends is important, kids.
You f*** with the wrong rock monster and you're dead. Last but not least, I'm going to mention how the game performs. This isn't something I usually talk about, however, it bears mentioning because this game is about as optimized as a block of wood glued to a cinder block. Well, I guess I'm on my own out here.
Hey, is that another person?
Hey! Hey! Over here! Hey! Oh, come on! Then it's off to create your, boy, I guess. You're in there. Okay, I'm gonna need to think this out thoroughly. You can also fuse the mods together to create better mods. You, Jun, ha! Shit. I'll be right back, I gotta go fix this.
Psst, dude, your balls are showing.
And I was absolutely no better with him than any other character. Good to know that I'm an equal opportunity sucker. Kinda like a prostitute. What is wrong with me today?
Throw in the aforementioned PvE, and you have quite a few different ways to play MXM. A lot more than your stereotypical MOBA. Hence, better. More always equals better. Like money, or sex, or drugs, or toilet paper.
And the Minotaur. He's a big bull with two axes. Don't try to milk him.
And then I got to watch a dragon be hatched from some freaky Fabergé egg. What the hell are humans not hatched from eggs in a fantastical light show? Thanks a lot, God.
I came across a shop where you can buy food and drink, which you'll need to fill your hunger and thirst meters. Not real sure how you fill your blood meter, though, and I'm not too sure I want to know.
And now, sadly, my time with Legion is done, for that is my curse. I have no time to waste. There are other games that must be looked at. Other games that must be made fun of.
Hive Leader, hooray!
I can't actually fly, I'm just gonna go.